So I thought I'd do something a little different with the channel today. I'm going to do a review of the books that I have read myself for the month of March. And those books are the Bookmobile Cat Mysteries by Laurie CASS. There's 7 books. I actually read all 7 books, so that can tell you that, you know, I like the series. It's about a lady named Minnie Hamilton. She's a Bookmobile librarian, and she has a cat named Eddie. He's a rescue cat, and they live in Michigan, and they solve mysteries. I love cozy mystery books, especially ones that are series. I really like getting into a series, and what I like is to listen to them on Hoopla, listen to the audiobooks, because then you can just do one right after the other. And especially now that you can't get out and get to the library or shouldn't go shopping at a bookstore, Hoopla is an excellent option. So I really like doing them one after the other, because then I feel like you're just into that world and you really get involved with everything that's going on. But I had a few problems with this. First off, I noticed there was a lot of similarities with Aurora Tea Garden. I don't know how many of you have ever read the Aurora Tea Garden mysteries, but Aurora Tea Garden is a little short librarian, and she has a cat, and she ends up solving murder mysteries. Well, Minnie Hamilton, just like her name, actually her real name is Minerva, but everyone calls her Minnie, is about 5 feet tall, so she's small, and she works at a library. The thing that makes her different is not only does she work at the library, she also runs the Bookmobile. So that lets her get out into the community and meet all these characters that she gets into her books and stuff. She also has a cat named Eddie, who, if you listen to the audiobooks, Eddie says "murr" a lot. And the first book or two, it kind of took me back every time the lady would go "murr," you know, because it was weird. But the more I got into the books and the more I started listening to it, and Eddie sort of got his own personality, like, I was awaiting the "murrs" and the different way that she would say them. So the person who actually does the audiobooks for this is excellent. That's a big part of listening to audiobooks for me. If the lady that, or the man that's doing the voices, you know, not got much personality or not someone that I can stand listening to, it just seems like it makes listening to the book even more difficult or even more hard to get into. But I wish I knew her name. I'll go out and find it later. I'll add it down in the comments. But the lady who did the read aloud for these books was excellent. They had a good choice. And I like it when they keep the same read aloud lady for the entire series, because then you get this voice in your head for the character, you know. And I hate it when I listen to audiobook series, especially since I like to listen to them, you know, back to back to back to back, and they change the reader. So all of a sudden your character has a different voice, and it's kind of disconcerting sometimes. But even though it was kind of similar to Aurora Tea Garden, and it's a cozy mystery, which, you know, chick lit, that's the kind of books that they make Hallmark mystery movies off of. You know, they're pretty predictable. You know how things are going to work out. But I really like them. I'm really into that right now. So I do like that. The one thing I didn't like about this is her love interest. Now, you know, it's a cozy mystery, so it's very PG rated and everything. You don't have to worry about curse words or, you know, any situations. But for the first couple of books, you're really rooting for her to get with one guy. Eventually she will, and it seems like almost in the next book they start to have problems, and then you start kind of rooting for her to get with another guy, you know, and then of course she gets with him, and it seems like it was like every other book she was with a different guy, so it kind of got, you know, you didn't really want to root for anybody anymore, because you're like, eh, she's just gonna dump him anyway. You know, and it's usually for what I would consider kind of silly reasons. So, the way the book ended, she's with some guy and she's calling him the love of her life. And I don't know. I don't know if there's another book. There's not another book. I don't know if there will be another book, but it's, I don't know. That kind of really bothered me. Another thing that bothered me, even though this was an excellent read aloud lady, she, in the first couple of books, pronounced things wrong. Like, she pronounced it Mackinac Island. And even me, not really knowing a lot about geography and not knowing that much about Michigan, I knew that it was Mackinac Island. And so that kind of bothered me every time she said Mackinac, you know? Because that's how it looks, but that's not how they actually pronounce it. In about the third or fourth book, I guess somebody told her, hey, you're saying that wrong. So she started fixing the way that she said that. So that helped out a lot. But yeah, you know, it's the little girl that works at the library looking for love and hanging out with her cat. And her cat becomes a bigger and bigger part of the book and helps her solve the mysteries and stuff. And it's kind of like that, you know, Murder, She Wrote. Why is this one lady around all of these dying people? You know, you start to think maybe she's a serial killer. So, but yeah, for just like a little light listen, something to kill the time. And there's a lot of books in the series. Like, I listened to all 7 books and it took me the entire month. You know, I like to just listen as I'm doing stuff around the house, or if I'm playing a game on my phone, I listen to it in the background and stuff. You know, I don't sit and just listen, and because I'll fall asleep if I don't if I listen to a book, if I'm not keeping myself occupied doing something else, I'll fall asleep. And that's the bad thing with audiobooks. If you fall asleep while you're listening to them, it's like impossible to find where you were. So, yeah, but overall, if you like the little cozy mystery books, the little lighthearted mysteries, I mean, these are actually decent mysteries. I mean, the killer wasn't completely obvious, you know. They did a pretty good job about that. So if you like little books like that, I would totally recommend this, you know, to download off of Hoopla and just listen and kill some time and have something to listen to while you're cleaning house or folding laundry or whatever. But yeah, if you guys like this idea of me doing book reviews, let me know. I'll keep doing them. I really appreciate all the love I've had for my channel lately. I can't believe how many subscribers I have, and I just think that I owe a lot of it to my kids. They really encouraged me to make this channel, and they participated in the Mariah Elizabeth pictures and doing the YouTube collaborations with me. And I'm a teacher, and right now I'm not getting to be with my kids. We are doing learning over the internet, but it's not the same. And I really miss them. So if my kids are listening to this, hi, Miss Morse misses you. Hopefully we'll get back in class soon. And I just hope all of you have a nice and safe day. God bless.